Hello there, it's Asia Marke here, Lemon Creation, and today I have for you a set of ATCs which I made not with Lindys for once. Well, there are some Lindys, but I made them with geli printed papers, actually leftovers of the papers, and some very weird bugs. So let's start. These are my leftover jelly printed pages. I didn't do them on for special purpose. They are just leftovers when I was cleaning my brayer, and I clean it on the normal copy printed paper. Copy printed paper, I think. Well, paper for printers. And so now I'm adding them to the cardstock base, which is the size of ATC cards. And why use the scissors for that if you're gonna get a little bit more interest by just tearing them apart? This one did not work out, the last one, so I add a little bit of other color, and I decided that this is the way to go, actually, to add some colors for the for each card, a little bit more colors. I glue them with the normal glue, which I stole from my children, because they are stealing constantly stuff from me. So also, why not? And that will hold just fine, because I don't need anything, you know, it's not anything sturdy, so I can work like that with it. Those are Thinlits from Team Holtz. Those three beautiful things, they come in a set, very nice, very useful. I use them quite often, especially the one with the honeycomb thing and the one which I'm tearing apart right now. And once again, the best way is to tear them apart instead of cutting them, because you'll get always just unexpected effects, which is super cool. As I mentioned at the very beginning of this video, I used the jelly printing, or I made the jelly printing, not with Lindys for once, because I use quite often Lindys, but this time I used actually acrylics, and if I'm not mistaken, they were PBO acrylics, because I really like them, and I'm sure I also added some PaperArtsy white chalk acrylic, which is also one of my favorite, and I'm dreaming about getting more colors. I only have one from PaperArtsy, and I just dream about having a little bit more, because I just absolutely love the white I have. And now I wanted to make the color a little bit softer, so for that I'm using white gesso and a brush. And here once again, there are some products I'm not super happy with. One is the tonic trimmer. I am absolutely unhappy with it. It doesn't cut well, and the customer service was really bad with me. I didn't manage to even order one replacement blade. And another thing is white gesso from Finnabair. It's not a super nice product. It says it's heavy gesso, but it is not, in my opinion anyway. So because of that, I didn't get this effect I really wanted. But I decided to continue, and I decided to add a little bit of more colors. I added some distress oxides, and for now they look quite bright, but I'll work on that a little bit later. And thinking about the products I'm not happy with, I think I'm gonna make some posts on my community tab, so check this out on YouTube, and so maybe we can share with the products, we can share our opinion about the products we are not happy with, because I think that, you know, it would be nice that we know what to avoid, simply because the craft products are quite expensive anyway, and it would be a nice thing, I think, to do, so we can share our opinions and maybe share our ideas on how to fix some products, and just share the knowledge, why not? And here we go, the star of the evening. it's a snowflake chalk acrylic from PaperArtsy, that's the one I was telling you about. And it covers much better than the heavy gesso from Finnabair. And I again didn't want to have these sparkling colors, so that's why I wanted to make it a little bit subtle, and that's why I'm using this time. I learned from my mistake, and I prefer to use the chalk acrylic instead of heavy gesso from Finnabair. And now I'm adding a little bit of black sauce again, just to make some shadows, because when you have or when you do stenciling or you add to your projects die cuts, it's very nice to add some shadows like that. You get this deepness because the paint, like for example the black paint I'm using here, or black distress, it tends to stack or stick in the small nooks and crannies, and like that it gives the deepness later to the whole project. For now it maybe look a little bit messy, but at the end, you know, to me anyway, it looks like a really finished project. And of course, with the stress oxides, you have to always dry it, because they will react with water. And another thing, also adding a little bit of interest, a little bit of finished effect, is inking the edges with black archival ink. In this case I did that because the whole ATCs, the three ATCs, are very pastely in color, so I felt like there is something needed, you know, something stronger if it comes to the color, to you know, to make a contrast basically. Wow, it's too late at night. I think I'm losing my mind a little, losing the words again. You've seen I showed you the bags I used. They were from Lesia Scherda, I think that's the way to pronounce her name, I'm not very sure. I stamped them on the cardstock paper, either or mixed media paper, with black archival ink, and this part I didn't actually show because I didn't want to make a long video. And after stamping I fuzzy cut them, and now I'm coloring them with water soluble oil pastels from Prima, and those pastels are really beautiful. I like working with them, especially for splatters. But I feel like I don't use them quite often, or not often enough. So this project was really basically about using other products than Lindy's Gang. Finally, I didn't manage even that, but that you're gonna see a little bit later. Coloring is not my strong suit, I admit, so I sped up the process a little bit, and especially these small bags are super tiny, so it's very hard to color them. And in the hindsight, I'd say I should have made more contrast on my ATC cards. But honestly, I usually make things with a lot of contrast, or at least I think. So this time I went a little for the same kind of hues of the same colors. And this was a great idea. I haven't used my glossy accents for a long time already. And I made these small carapaces, I think. You know, with glossy accent, I fill them up so they look, after drying, a little bit more like bugs. I added some stamping accents with a paper poetry script stamp. I don't use acrylic block because like that the impression I'm making, it's not really very even, it's finishing, you know, very in the random points, so it's cool that way, I like it. This is kind of, again, a little bit of distressing stamping. I added also some numbers, and I think that's it for stamping. Use some die cuts, if I'm not mistaken they are from Alexandra Renke, and well, yes, I cracked. I'm using Lindy Skunk products, Oktoberfest Orange, Teal the Wheel Teal, and obviously black embossing powder. Ah no, there is one more, Imperial Chrome Purple Polka, I think, I'm not sure. The reason for that is simply because I don't have any other embossing powders, really, only Lindy's, and they work really beautifully. And so I'm gonna do my funny embossing. I'm gonna emboss the branches with a few different colors. This is a lifesaver, one of the best buys I've ever made. Embossed pen from Ranger. It comes in white and black color. You have to always keep it clean, so be careful with that, because otherwise you can break it. But if by any chance your whole embossed image didn't get enough ink, you can always fix it with this pen. And you can also draw your own funky lines with it, and that's why it comes also with two colors, because the black one you will see actually what you are drawing, while the white one, if you for example want to use with the clear embossing powder, you can use the white one and it's not gonna be visible. So super cool and nice buy, really. If you were thinking about it, I really recommend it. I forgot to show you how I add the words to it, but well, I just glue them simply. And that's what I'm saying by thinking that they are maybe a little bit in the same coloring, the stuff. There is one blue, one purple and one orange, but at the same time, why not? Just to change the things a little bit. And I absolutely love the torn edges of the paper with the blank ink also. This is it for today, guys. I hope you like it. It was a different project because there was no painting with Lindy's, even though there was embossing with Lindy's, and I don't do the geli printing that often also. So it was fun. I wish you a beautiful day, stay safe, and see you in my next video. And please don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button to be notified about my videos. Bye bye! Thank you.